For the past few days, you may have heard of the term the Great Recession. And the reason why everyone is talking about it is today's global economy has been drowned to the levels beneath we have never, ever calculated. But before we start speaking from the topic of this video, let us revisit what economy is and how it works. And don't worry, it's not going to be a boring lecture. So the economy in simple terms is the trade language. Improved standards of living are made possible when labor is more productive. Productivity is driven by specialization, technological innovation, and working capital. The only sustainable way for an economy to grow is through increased productivity. To put it in more simple words, the economy works when there are demand and the supply to fulfill. Since the beginning of the year 2020, the demand for certain commodities increased and then vanished. People capitalized on the production and sales of what now experts are calling the New World Order. With the world being quite like a science fiction movie with an overheated pilot, it appears as though that we are on the verge of a change that we've never seen before. The methods of running businesses that were adopted by everyone in the world proved to be not ready for something this big. I mean, just look at the graph. We were just 20 days into the global lockdown, and the stock market has dropped by 20% in comparison to 2008's global financial crisis, which took the stock market 517 days to drop by 56%. The oil which ran the world didn't even have a single buyer, which is never expected to ever happen. The airline companies went bankrupt within a week. And to come out of this depression, even if someone handed a bunch of money, and by that, I mean someone around $9 trillion worth of money, that would just increase the debt of the entire world. The economy has flushed. Work from home has increased, and the gig economy seems to be the future of the global services businesses, and the idea of cryptocurrencies has started to become a part of serious discussions. Since I mentioned that the economy is going to be obsolete, now it can be understood in a much better way. You see, the US dollar is the world's most powerful currency. It runs the international trade, and the stock market's worth is calculated in the US dollars for the same reason. Since the US dollar has been running things around for quite a while now, and these crises have taken away that power to a great extent, the question arises, who will be the next global superpower? Well, we know the United States isn't going anywhere, but is there room for another superpower? Who's going to control the things around? As the lockdowns are being lifted, the buying patterns of the average consumer has changed, and it looks as though the change is here to stay. Which raises a question. Is China going to be the hub of the new global economy? As of today, China has developed its financial markets, but the currency itself is still not convertible. And if that happens in the future, it will challenge the US dollar as the world's global currency. Experts suggest that there will be a rethink of how much any country wants to be reliant on any other country in the future. When big, convulsive economic events happen, the implications tend to take years to play out and spiral in unpredictable directions. Who would have thought that a stock market crash in New York in 1929 would contribute to the rise of the fascists in Europe in the 1930s? The world economy is an infinitely complicated web of interconnections. We each have a series of direct economic relationships we can understand. The stores we buy from, the employer that pays our salary, the bank that makes us a home loan. But once you get two or three levels out, it's impossible to know why any confidence how these connections work. In the years ahead, we will learn what happens when the web is torn apart, when millions of those links are destroyed all at once. And it opens the possibility of a global economy completely different from the one that has prevailed in recent decades. As much as we want the global economic activity back to normal, what's dangerous is this is just the beginning of our problems. The magnitude of the uncertainty is beyond anything we can ever be used to. And having discovered that we can work just as well from home, the white-collar workers will no longer be willing to make those daily commutes to downtown office buildings, forever changing the nature of work and triggering a mass exodus from the major cities, New York, Seattle, San Francisco, and other expensive and densely populated cities. The sudden shift to online shopping will bring on the demise of the department stores like potentially Walmart, while wiping out the majority of independent retailers and restaurants. Meanwhile, hundreds of colleges and universities will be forced to close their doors, while those that survive will finally embrace the radiological and economic logic of teaching most of their courses online. Inequality of income and wealth will accelerate, racial disparities will widen, and government at all levels will be constrained by crippling levels of debt. There is, of course, a germ of truth and a measure of logic behind many of these prognostications. But if history is any guide, once a vaccine has been found and the economic storm has passed, life will return pretty much the way it was before. Yet again, this age of technology and connectivity will force the employers around the world to think if the hefty operational costs are worth it, which will keep the less productive or less skilled workers at bay, hence increasing the rate of unemployment. At this point, the switch which was supposed to fix everything once the normal life resumes is broken, and the time required to fix it is unknown. No one can be held responsible, and neither a single entity can turn things around. We don't want to go back to the 1930s, and we don't want to trigger a sudden bout of inflation, but as of yet, we don't yet have a global replacement. Until we do, it seems very likely that we will get more of the downside than the upside of this deglobalization. The world will never be the same again, which has been repeated so many times before, ever since the global economy faced a juggling halt, and we have seen how fragile the superpowers of the world are. So, if you guys have gotten to the end of the video, I'd like you to share your thoughts with us on how there can be better opportunities for employment and higher quality lives in the comments below. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and stay up to date on our next video if you enjoyed this one. Thanks for watching.